when people look at it, it looks crazy. That's a very natural thing. Sometimes when we look at it, it looks crazy. But it still looks crazy. From the top of the atmosphere, down to the surface, it takes us 7 minutes. It takes 14 minutes or so for the signal from the spacecraft to make it to Earth. That's how far Mars is away from us. So when we first get word that we've touched the top of the atmosphere, the vehicle has been alive or dead on the surface for at least 7 minutes.
Is by using the sky crane maneuver.
20 meters above the surface, we have to lower the rover below us on a tether that's 21 feet long and then gently deposit it on its wheels on the surface.
As the rover touches down and is now on the ground, the descent stage, it's in a collision course with the rover. We must cut the bridle immediately and fly the descent stage to a safe distance from the rover.
Because this test is so important to the project, almost all of the team wanted to gather and watch the test. We actually projected it into multiple conference rooms around the lab.
Fire.
Welcome to the NASA training session for how to make a photograph for Mars. Now, folks, I have to keep keeping this training session because we have to keep firing people. We've got very, very easy guidelines to go by. All you got to do is find a piece of land on Earth, something maybe has rocks in it or something like that that you see right here. It doesn't matter if it's green, folks. Because we're going to make it not green and they'll believe anything we tell them. And what we're going to do is we're going to turn it into something that looks a lot like this. Okay, because everybody gets this wrong, we have to keep firing them. You cannot allow green to show in the photograph. So the first thing that you got to do is you got to go up to your colors and you got to desaturate everything. We're going to give it color, but we're only going to give it one color. Because that's what these idiots believe, is they believe that Mars is just red. So next thing we got to do is we got to make the sky look completely fake. And what we do is we color the sky one solid color, like we have right here. All right, once you got your sky and you got your ground looking okay, make sure y'all don't leave that van out there like that. We've had people do that before. Then what you're going to do is you're going to colorize it. And then we're going to make it the color of choice, and it's going to be something about like that right there. All right, and then we just need to add our final touch. And once you throw our little rover on there, those idiots won't know any better. And see what you can accomplish with just 5 minutes of work. But I'm warning you, y'all need to stop putting the green in your photographs, because people are finding out. So let's take a look at the comparison. And here you go. We have before, and we have after.
And I think that this nation is a truly great representation of a corner or a piece of humanity that reaches out and explores and conquers and engineers. We are kind of tool makers, agriculturalists. Unrivaled.
California and on Mars, I want to present to you the team that has brought us back to Mars tonight.
So, about an hour and a half ago, I went outside and looked toward the west, and I saw Mars there, and I said, in an hour and a half, you are going to have a visitor. And the planet smiled, and I knew that we were going to have good luck.
And a guy who was sweating through this, and as he told me a little while ago, he thought he was going to throw up.
Well, today on Mars, history was made on Earth.
Okay, guys, before we start, we have a new picture of Mars. Come in. I'm sure all of you want to hear about how things went. Well, tonight was a great drama that was played. I felt like an adventure movie, but in reality, I kept telling myself, this is real. This is real, what's happening, and what a fantastic demonstration.
And congratulations to all of you again.
Thank you. Welcome to Rich Planet TV. On last week's show, we presented the Mars Rover Hypothesis, in which I suggested that the Mars rovers, which according to NASA, landed on Mars and are sending back images of Mars, could in fact be at remote locations on the Earth as part of a well-organized deception. We examined photographs produced by NASA, allegedly taken from the Martian surface, which appear to show objects commonly found on the Earth. Starting with a small rodent, identified possibly as an Arctic lemming, a lump of wood, possibly from an old railway sleeper, the vertebra of a large sea creature, a bone identified possibly as a walrus arm bone, lichen growing on rocks, a crinoid fossil, and also photographs which prove NASA have falsified the colours in many of their images. The question which arises is, do these anomalies provide evidence that all the images from the Mars rovers are in fact being taken from remote locations on the Earth?
And just think what an inspiration to the young people in the world. It's really inspiring. This is how inspirational. And what a bargain that we got this mission for. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen. And look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen. And next week, and next month, and next year, we'll be bringing new discovery every day, every week to all of you. And we are going to continue.
There are many out in the community who say that NASA has lost its way, that we don't know how to explore, that we've lost our moxie. I want you to look around tonight, all those folks with the blue shirts, think about what we've achieved. I think it's fair to say that NASA knows how to explore, we've been exploring, and we're on Mars. And the rover is made in the USA. And just to stay in character, we've been on the surface for 1 hour, 8 minutes, and 16 seconds. And certainly for the 7 minutes of terror, has started to weave, you know, an unbelievable story. As we get ready to transition to surface ops, I think what we really need to pay attention to now is that the Curiosity story is just beginning.
So that rocked. Seriously, was that not cool or what? Woo! Woo! So that rocked. Seriously, was that not cool or what? Woo! And is that Mount Sharp? What can I see there? And all kinds of stuff. And so he's definitely, he's got the keys pretty soon. Not quite yet, but pretty soon he'll have the keys. Yeah. And then here, Dr. Stelzner has been the father and the mother and everything in between of the landing system we've built. So. Something profound.
I am terribly humbled by this experience. I forever, secretly, have felt that I do not deserve to be in the position of leading the team that I lead, because they are certainly in sum and largely by count of individual more capable than I. Soup to nuts. And I think that this nation is a truly great representation of a corner or a piece of humanity that reaches out and explores and conquers and engineers. We are kind of tool makers, agriculturalists, pioneers, and that's reflected in the activities and actions and results of tonight. So I want to say thank you to the blue shirts. Certainly this beautiful theater of tonight, the drama of us all being able to experience it together, unrivaled in the experience for all of us. And with that, really, I have nothing more to say. That picture says it all for me.
I think that is the best picture of Mars I've ever seen. The money, $2.5 billion, We don't put it in the rover and send it to Mars. We spend it here on Earth. And Charles mentioned at the beginning that this whole enterprise, if you divide it by every woman, child, man in this country, comes out to be the cost of the movie. I know, I speak on behalf of all my colleagues in science, that's a movie I want to see. So thank you all.
Adam, tell us about the landing.
All right, Greg. I can't tell you too much about it. I mean, it looks good. I'm being a little flip. In short, it looked extremely clean. We touched down in conditions that were on the more benign side of our nominal expectation. By the way, I want to preface everything. This is preliminary data scooped with the sieve in the cacophony of the control room during the celebration, right? And largely by my good friend Miguel San Martin, who's somewhere out there. I hope. At any rate, very nominal, remarkably good. Our navigation error was on the low side of our expectation, which meant that we probably had a good alignment between the celestial center sensors and the inertial sensors, the IMU. Our powered flight appears to have been excellent. If my good friend Ben Toma is in the house, is Ben in the house? So it looked good, in short. Good and clean. And it looks, at least by my eyeball, that we landed in a nice, flat spot. Beautiful. Really beautiful.
What? I have to ask you, what kind of file type? Can you tell us about the image file type and compression that was used to send this very important couple of thumbnails back from Mars?
Yes, unfortunately, I absolutely cannot. If Justin Mackey is in the room, or there's a couple other people on the team who'd be able to whip that out quickly, but I don't, couldn't tell you. Sorry.
Are you going to call your daughter Curiosity? Okay, a serious question. A little more than 48 hours ago, you told me you would tell me a secret. Once Curiosity landed, can I have my secret?
Yeah, what was this? A lot has happened in the last 48 hours. And to be very truthful, I do not recall what that secret was.
For the landing that go down to something like 5 decimal points. I just wanted to confirm with you that you do have those sort of coordinates. And am I reading those coordinates correctly when I see that it looks as though you've landed within 500 meters of the skirt around the mountain? That, I mean, you're really very close to the mountain at the closer end in the landing ellipse, and possibly within striking distance of the phyllosilicate trench.
I can't confirm that. My estimate, I'm looking for somebody. Yes, there's somebody in the audience here who has that in the tip of their noggin.
Looking at the picture and trying to figure out from there where we are, I would imagine by tomorrow's press conferences, they should have a better idea where it came down, within a few hundred meters at least, hopefully.
Okay, the next question's over on this side.
Was when Adam asked for OD 278, and they said, no, we only have 277. What was happening, or was it anything of significance?
No.
And what a bargain that we got this mission for. This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen. And look at the excitement that we have brought and the inspiration that we have brought.
sometimes when this place gets kind of empty. Sound of their breath fades with the light. I think about the loveless fascination under the Milky Way tonight. Lower the curtain down.
Seriously, is that not cool or what? Woo! Woo! Down
I got no time for private consultation under the Milky Way tonight. Wish I knew what you were looking for. Might have known.
Is that not cool or what? Woo! Woo!
Something shimmering and white. It leads you here.
And at the NASA briefing today, they called the surroundings Earth-like and admitted it looks like the Mojave Desert for all you conspiracy theorists.
Dispatch your destination.
Seriously, is that not cool or what?
Woo! Everybody see them. Everybody see them.
Wish I knew what you were. Might I know what you were
saying? Agriculturalist. My good friend Miguel San Martin is somewhere out there. I hope. Soup to nuts. If Justin Mackey is in the room or. A couple other people on the table to be able to whip that out quickly, but I'm my yes. I'm looking for somebody. Yes. There's somebody in the audience here who has a noggin.
This movie costed you less than $7 per American citizen.